We gotta run all the way back. And just make our minds where we're going and just stay there. And then continue on and not go back. Wake up. We made it again. Jig says, look, the McBain Company. Hopping. What's up? Your leg's healed already? McBain says, oh, you're the boy with the broken leg. What's up? Woof! Squeak! What's wrong with you two? You guys are no fun, says McBain. Forte says, listen, don't you think there's something weird? About what? What happened to your broken bone? Asked Una. Ah, you're right. It's totally healed. Well, I'm totally healed. Funny thing. I thought that maybe it's been months. Maybe every time we run back and forth to Polka, you know, it's been months. Because, you know, time in the game world runs differently than real time. Yeah, I guess it shouldn't take months to go 500 milos, I don't know. Like the Elder Scrolls Arena, you play the game, I forget how long it took me, like 80, 90 hours to play it, but the game takes place over 10 years, because you have to go to every province to get every staff piece, and then finally, you know, get the last one and they all connect together and you have the Staff of Chaos. It's supposed to be take like 10 years. So. But, yeah, not in this case. I can't believe it, says McBain. There's no way the broken bone would heal that fast. Ha ha ha. Are you surprised, says Jig? Yes. We are. Tori says, you must be amazed. Yeah, totally, says McBain. After you departed, a young lady came to the village. She was a beautiful girl with beautiful black hair. McBain says, really? A beautiful girl with beautiful black hair, huh? What are you in a frenzy over? Asks Forte. Not sure if he's talking to McBain or Tori. She was really a beautiful girl, says Tori. I was surprised when she came here and started singing all of a sudden, though. McBain says, you said she had started singing suddenly? Just repeat everything she says in the form of a question. She had a very clear voice, says Jake. Just listening to her made my body feel light and my legs started to move. Really? Says Una. Your broken leg was healed by listening to her song? I can't believe it, says McBain. But it's true, Jake says. Not only that, I feel I can run faster than before. Is that person still in a village, says Forte? No, says Tori. She left without telling us. I didn't even say thank you to her. She was really like a phantom. Wow. First the dolls and now the lady with black hair. There are a lot of strange things going on lately. She was really a mysterious person. It was as if she was from an outside world. I wonder if she was the lake spirit. The lake spirit, says Una. There's a legend connected to Lake Wyolina in the west that the kind-hearted spirit helps the travelers to get lost. Or the villagers in trouble. Maybe I should pay a visit to thank her with my brother sometime. Lake spirit, huh? Maybe we'll find her at the lake, I guess. Possible. See what the old lady's doing.
That girl with black hair is not an ordinary girl. She healed not only my pain in the back, but also blew my stuffed shoulders and fatigue away. I've never had such an experience before. She must be the lake spirit. I'm glad that I've lived long enough to see it.
Yeah. Just peek in here. Just in case anyone's standing around. A lady with black hair? Yeah, she was here. She healed my husband with her mysterious singing voice. It was as if I had been dreaming. I wonder where she was from. She didn't look like a singer from Cavaro either. She was such a mysterious girl. I was bleeding from the cut until now, but it's completely closed now. That girl might be an angel. A lady with black hair came here. She sang a beautiful song for my daddy, and his injury was healed. I heard that a lady with black hair healed injured people. I wish I could have given a kiss to show my appreciation. Giving a kiss is a sign of appreciation, understand? It's a sign of something. It could be a sign of a few different things. There's a rumor that a girl treated injured people. When they heard the mysterious singing voice, their injuries and broken legs were healed. How many broken legs did they have? I wonder if it's true. McBain says, I also took a look at a boy whose bone was broken, but he was truly healed. It's so mysterious, says Carbo. Oh, I really wanted to meet the lady with black hair.
The girl with black hair? I bet she is the lake spirit.
All the villagers are talking about the girl with black hair. Those who couldn't meet her are a little jealous. To be honest, I'm one of them. Anyway, I'm glad there wasn't much damage. There's one other house, I think. Nope, maybe that's it. That's the father who was hurt, and then the other, we came from the other house. Alright, I guess we're done here. I bought the restore snuff here. Okay. Oh, let me get down here. Can we really go to the lake now? That'd be awesome. Wyolina Road. Well, I haven't heard this song in forever. Well, everything's west from here. Cavaro. But before that... is the Wyolina Lake, I believe. Oh, a chest. Orb of Ocean 43. Orb of Ocean 44. The only game I've ever heard where you check the... I've ever played where you check the back of a chest to make sure there's nothing still in there. I doubt we'll find all these. Which one did I just find? 43 and 44, I think? An image of Palman? Palman shouting? Oh. It's the captain. Yeah, it's gotta be that. Hmm. It's this way. Does this just go around? Yeah. This just goes around this rock. Comment on here, just walking through a bunch of lands with creatures who don't want to attack us, that's fine. Oh, one of those little things. Been a while. The owl, I love it. Lake Wyolina. Someone is singing? Beautiful girl with beautiful black hair. Beautiful voice, says Una. Her voice moves me, says McBean. Look! Over there, Forte says. Sure is a beautiful voice, says Una. Where's where we came from? It stopped. Ah, she's gone, says Forte. I'm sure that she was singing around here, McBain says. She disappeared like a ghost, Una says. McBain says, in some respects, this forest road is mysterious. It's no wonder ghosts appear, considering the atmosphere here. Hmm, says Forte, but she was more like the spirit of Lakeside than a ghost. Jan's saying, woof. Huh? McBain says. Jan, what's going on? Says Una. The dog knows. Ah. Grandpa, this is the crest of Leon. Oh, so this is the place where the map has been responding. It's locked, says Una. Looks like this lock was installed by the nearby villager, McBain says. I can't just break it on my own. Well, what should we do? The door is locked. Cruel fate, how dare you? Well, we have to find another way to get in. Or some kind of structure here. Devour is west. Lakeside shops. Alright, I'll talk to him last. Money member says, woof. I can't sleep well, even though I came to such a beautiful lake. Maybe it's too quiet. Yawning. Are you troubadours by any chance? How about playing something to make me fall asleep? Una says, it's terrible not to be able to sleep, huh? Hmm, says McBain. I get irritated when I can't fall asleep because I take too long of a nap. Oh, beforehand? Grandpa. Come on, Forte. Let's play for him, says Una. Yes. Okay. I don't know if we can help, though. McBain says, I would like as quiet and relaxing music as possible. You can just fall asleep here on the floor. I mean, there's no chairs. I don't know how to describe it, but it felt like my heart became clear and relaxed. Really? Says Forte. Yeah, it was soothing and relaxing. I think I might be able to go to sleep. I'm sorry that I can't pay with cash. Forte and his friends receive a doll night 12. Yay. Are you sure? Says Forte. I feel bad that it's all I can do for you. I'm going straight to bed. Good night. Grandpa Rad says, it's my bed. McBain says, looks like we could help him. Not only could you, but you did. Forte says, we don't get many chances to play this kind of place, huh? Chances. Music has to be like this at its heart. It's nice to perform in front of the big audience, but we can also play for only one person. Forte says, there are different styles of performance by an increment in the numbers of audience. Oh, it was well spoken, McBain says. You're so right about that. Okay. Music is back. I'm sleeping. Zzz.
She had a wonderful voice. I felt like my lifespan was extended for another 10 years when I heard her sing. I was looking forward to fishing here, but I got a pot of gold at the end of the rainbow.
For some reason, I got to liking this place. My life is willy-nilly, so I decided to start my own business here. Okay. We don't need that stuff. You say anything else? No. She just rent rooms. Yes, she does. Alright, that's it for this. Before I talk to him, I'm gonna look around this area. We came from that way. Can I walk along here? No. I can go this far. I guess our head hits the window or something. The overhang. I mean, are there any other buildings here? McBain says the resonance stone must be somewhere around here. Let's check it out. I'm trying to go around the building, dude. Okay. Alright, so we have to talk to this one guy. Because he came from here. Yeah. It's like a little lakeside inn or something. Inn's Winery. Hey, welcome. First time in Lake Wyolina? McBain says, I used to pass through here several times till 10 years ago, but it is the first time for these children. Not that I knew such a good inn had been built here either. Thank you. I started 5 years ago. There's quite a difference between Edel and Cavaro. I'm doing pretty good business. Forte asks, we saw a girl singing by the lakeside, but is she a native from here? Did you hear? Didn't she have a great voice? I'm sorry, but she's not from here. Forte says, so she's the spirit as expected? Or a ghost? Asks Una. Ha ha ha, no way. She is a human. Her name is Aria, and she sometimes uses my inn. She just checked out after staying here for a few days. Her name is Aria. I see, says Forte. Yeah, that's a musical term. says McBain. So her name is Aria. Which means a long accompanied song for a solo voice, typically one in opera or oratorio. So you just don't even know what oratorio is, but I'm gonna stop looking up terms and continue. I don't mean to be rude, but this place doesn't look like somewhere a young girl would come by herself. Yeah, I was wondering about that too. Every time she comes, she does nothing but looks at the lake in front of the shrine all day long. She was a mysterious girl, I must say. Speaking of the shrine, who locked it? Asked Forte. Oh, that was me. It's closed with a lid, but it's connected to the cave in the back. I thought it would be dangerous if a traveler wandered off into it. That's why I locked it. Would you mind lending us the key to it? McBain asked. No, but there's nothing in that cave. Una says, well, did you see the strange crest carved on the door? It's something left by a composer named Leon. Forte says, we are visiting the places which are connected to him while on a tour. Leon. You mean Leon F. Richter? Oh, you know about him, says McBain. I should have known because you live near the city of art, Cavaro. I see. That's what it is. I was wondering who made it, but it didn't even cross my mind that Leon did. Okay. In that case, I'm happy to lend you the key. They received shrine key from the inn owner. Oh, well, thanks. Most of the customers here are tourists to Cavaro, since it's close. Many tourists to Cavaro like music. For that reason alone, they like Leon, too. In addition, the natives of Cavaro are die-hard Leon fans. I can attract more customers if there's something related to Leon. Please let me know if you find something interesting in the shrine. I'll make it a tourist attraction. Let me just check one more time. Same thing. Alright. We got the key. I got the key. I got the key. Key to the shrine near the lake. Promise to return to Wily from the inn after use. That's his name, Wily? This is Inn's Winery. Wily from the winery. The door of the shrine was unlocked. Good. Let's open the door, says McBain. Forte says, no mistake, it's a dangerous place if a traveler wandered off. This is close to the road, says Una, so it's easy to get off track and enter without knowing. But Grandpa Mac, didn't you enter the shrine when you passed by before? I didn't have magic map back then. I had no clue that there was such a place as the shrine that Leona hid the resonance stone in. Shall we go inside, says Forte? I remember all this. The ancient letters are engraved. An accurate operation, don't use the same lever. It sounds difficult, says Una. McBain says, well, if it's too easy to figure out, anyone could do it. Let's see, we gotta use our brain. Huh. Well, I don't know about any levers. Let's go this way, I guess. Okay. Special door. What about this way? Another one? Oh! Three levers. That's what it's talking about. So, I'm betting we have to put the levers in a certain configuration to open this. Use rock crash. Or... maybe not. Oh, it's another lever. There's a lever. Do you want to pull it down? Yes. Forte and his friends pull down the lever. So, it says... don't use the same lever. We're stopping. Question mark. Oh, now there's a bunch of monsters. Oh, okay. Mad Eye and Smog. Well. I'm gonna make a guess that the smogs are more dangerous. Let's put Smog B to sleep, if we can. And the rest of us will attack Mad Eye B, and we'll try to get some of these special attacks going. That's funny how they're both at 99 hit points. Jan and Rick and Una. See if Smog can sleep. Smog can sleep. There we go. Shining arrow. We're gonna wake that one up. Yeah, we woke it up, but we killed one of those other things. Mad Eye. Yeah, I guess those are all eyes, huh? Let's put the Smog Bee back to sleep. We'll attack Mad Eye A. There's Jan and Rick are attacking. Okay. I like to save these, I don't know. Trying to get this dog charge going. Oops. I want the charge dog. Speaking of charge dog... wait a second, what's Forte doing? Attacking... yeah, that's sleeping. Let that sleep. Paro Paro. Alright, I think I'm gonna save those other two. Full meters. Missed. Finish off the Mad Eye. maybe. Nice. Wakey, wakey. Let me just go back and check this thing. Don't use the same lever. Wait a second. Did this just reset? So even though that resets itself, we should not use it, I think, because it says don't use the same lever. Okay, so we turn that one. The lever doesn't move. Huh. Oh, none of them move. I'm not sure what they mean by the same lever. So I couldn't move any of them. I couldn't even move that other one down. Oh wait, do we have to attack the monsters again? Ugh! Every time? Well, they all reset. Ay, ay, ay. Alright. Smog B. Paralyzed. How do I get these? Well, I guess he can't do the charge dog if he's paralyzed. I say we got two people paralyzed and one almost dead or unconscious. Okay, she doesn't have a skill that can do anything. That's also a skill. Curing paralysis. Lackety paste. Lackety schmackety. I should have healed him. Okay, we got one person. Who's not paralyzed? Una. All right. Resurrect powder. Oh, yeah, I want to save that. Sorry, McBain, you got resource enough. Okay, that's it. We're apparently dead. I haven't saved the game in a... I have not saved the game in an hour and a half. Anyway, see you guys in the next episode when we are back here and we'll figure out the lever puzzle. I'm gonna have to do all this over again. Yay me. Thanks so much for watching. See you next time, and always seek adventure.